Communication is everything when it comes to severe weather situations, and the ham radio operators can communicate when the power is on and, more importantly, when the power is off. I spoke with the Grand Strand amateur radio operators to find out what exactly they do and see just what it takes to be a ham.
It's a passion, it's a hobby and a service.
KI4 JKV, I have you full quieting.
You have the ability to pick frequencies that gives you a million opportunities to be able to communicate.
We're still on the air when a lot of people go off the air.
And during a hurricane, power can be out for more than just a couple of hours. It could be days, or in the worst case scenario, even weeks.
And you have, unfortunately, so many people grabbing for cell phones that it overloads the circuits.
I'm able to get up and pack my stuff in a bag and go at a moment's notice if I needed to.
I've been through Floyd. I've been through four brushes, and we have had the power go out at the schools where there was an occasion we were the only communication.
Ham radio operators work closely with county emergency management. They recommend what emergency equipment may help them, and more importantly, find out where their service is most needed.
It's a great tool, not only as a backup in case we would lose all the other communication systems that we have, but they also routinely keep us up to date on what's going on with shelter numbers.
During an evacuation, the goal is for one amateur radio operator to go to every shelter or school and set up shop. There's no telling how long their service may be needed, but the hams are prepared to stay.
We try to make sure our equipment will stay in that kind of condition, so if it's needed, it'll work.
I can be able to go and set up, throw a wire up in the trees, and communicate outside the area.
To other amateur radio operators around the county, state, and even the country.
When all else fails, amateur radio works.
Ham radio operators work on a volunteer basis, providing their service during severe weather without any compensation. Lindsay Milbourne, News 13.